What's happening, folks? Back with another reaction, back with some more Simple Minds. And we're going back to the New Gold Dream album, 81, 82, 83, 84, which is from 82. I did want to give a big shout out again to Han Solo, Philip, and Stefan, all of whom have shared Simple Minds with me. And yeah, we're going to listen to the final tune on the album, which is called King is White. What's the second part? And in the Crowd. I don't know, it's interesting. I mean, kings and crowds, it, you know, calls to mind, you know, medieval public events, or Middle Ages, I should say. I feel like one of my grad student mentors shaking his head at me. Nevertheless, yeah, ultimately, you know, it suggests, you know, the spectacle of a public execution or something like that. So I don't know, the king being in the crowd, that wouldn't normally happen. If the king was in the crowd, perhaps he was in disguise, you know, perhaps there was some reason to be incognito. King is white, I mean, I don't know, I really don't know what to make of that. So we'll see what it is. If it's like a phrase, you know, from some literary source or otherwise, I'm not familiar with it. So yeah, like I said, it's giving me the scene of a, you know, a high Middle Ages public execution or something, but I doubt that'll have anything to do with it. So let's find out. This is Simple Minds, King is White and In the Crowd. I was going to comment on the percussion of that intro, and then it changed colors. With the relentless, driven percussion. this persistently with that intensity. Also, the vocal performance. Hello again. So I found out afterward my intro got cut off, so what I was about to say is the atmosphere of their tunes really is like another dimension. It just feels like I go to this place where I don't even know where I am, but it's compelling and it's thick with feeling and intensity. Now, admittedly, it's another one where I'm not sure what's happening vocally. Fair to say, speaking of the vocals, I feel like his intensity and his shout delivery, his, you know, rapid ramp-ups of intensity, I don't remember him doing that persistently at any point, so really interesting vocals on this one, even though if the net result is essentially the same, where I caught a handful of words here and there. Not sure what's happening thematically, but a really cool tune sonically that had me, you know, lost in another world for, what was that, like five and a half minutes? Actually just more than seven, so it was even longer than it felt like, which, you know, it's usually a good indication that I'm very immersed in a tune when it's over and it's like, oh, you know, nice 5 minute tune. No, it's actually a couple minutes longer than that, so top track. I do have the next album downloaded. Once again, shout out to all champions of the channel, but in this case I went to Phillips Collection. So apparently the next album is called Sparkle in the Rain, from 1984. So I have that ready to go, so we'll go through that, we'll begin going through it next time. So big ups to all the champions of the channel. Do let me know what you think of this. I will see you next time. Peace.